माय नेम इज शैलेंद्र शर्मा. आई एम इंडियन, आई एम ए हिंदू, आई एम ए वेरी ऑर्डिनरी पर्सन. आई वर्शिप माई कुल देवता विच इज शिवा एंड आई प्रैक्टिस वॉट माई गुरु टॉट मी. दीज आर माई सिंपल इंट्रोडक्शन. एंड एज ए योगी आई कंसिडर द होल वर्ल्ड एज माई फैमिली. सो आई डोंट थिंक इट इज वेरी मच नेसेसरी टू गिव माई जेनेटिक फैमिली बैकग्राउंड. I think in anybody's life, sometimes a situation arises. Finding out the answer to a certain question becomes extremely important and even becomes the purpose of your life. So I went through such circumstances much earlier in my life, and I came across a very great book, Autobiography of a Yogi, which was somehow uncannily very familiar to me. And my journey began way back from 1979. Then I went all over India searching for a guru, and I find him in Banaras, a grandson of Ladi Mahashay, who graciously agreed to initiate me on 1st October 1982. Since then, the journey is on. Oh, there were so many misadventures. I went through many fake gurus. Sadly, I will say as my own experience that everybody who talks about God and spirituality and yoga may not be a very genuine person. It is up to you how you take them. We all have our share about such people. So going through so many misadventures, finally, I found the right person who agreed to be my guru. When I reached his house, it was evening time, and before that I have never ever seen a group of so old people together. There were more than 20 old people sitting there, and a very old person was reading Bhagavat, and my guru was sitting very unassumingly there like a elderly person in any family, and I failed to recognize him because I had never seen a photograph of him before. But the feeling was extremely queer. I have never seen so old people together, and they were all looking at me. I was hardly 25 then. Then He gestured me to sit down, and then I recognized he's Heath. Next day, he initiated me. Realized this 2 years back. There is a new relative. He is very old man. He lives in Bhopal. He was serving in Allahabad then in 1978 or 79. Some South Indian officer came. He wanted to go to Lahari Masha's house, so he requested him, "Can you please guide me to his house?" And they found out and they took him to my guru's place. So that elderly person visited my guru 4-5 times. And as it is a very, say, habit of Indians to ask, who will carry on after you, because my guru was already old then. And he said, a young man is being prepared in Gwalior. He is very strong physically, highly educated, and very intelligent. But he never told me that. Now I realize why he didn't tell me, because if I was to carry on after him, maybe I will not be so hard in my practice, or maybe my ego will be so out of proportion. So I think it was a good thing he never told me then. But he told me in 1984, on 28th of February. I think it is my destiny, or maybe it's a plan from Babaji. As a fifth guru of the lineage, I think he is taking very good care of me. And whatever situation he will create for me to be in, I will be there. So I think it is his stage, and we are just doing what he wanted us to do. I think it is my nature. I just want to see beauty around me. So we did our best to create it here. And here, I will say a very important thing. This is the same place which was looking extremely dangerous and horrible. Same situation, same thing. But I just created a little hard work, and now how beautiful it looks. That also tells us a person will be the same, his life will be the same. But if he will work to beautify his life, the life will be very beautiful. I don't go out from this premises, which is a very ancient cremation site, where even Krishna's 16,000 queens were cremated, as Srimad Bhagavat tells us. And what I will do outside? I am a jobless person, I have no business, where I will go? And another thing, people are coming to see me, and I don't want to disappoint them by not being here. I like it here. I am very happy that it is a royal private shamshan. It's not a common shamshan, otherwise living here would be very difficult. It's a very private place, and I think this much breathing space is required for any yogi. I feel very good here. योगेश्वर कृष्णा इज सेइंग यदा यदा धर्मस्य ग्लानिर्भवति भारत अभ्युत्थानम धर्मस्तदात्मानम सृजाम्यह परित्राणाय साधुनां विनाशाय च दुष्कृतां धर्म संस्थापनार्थाय संभवामि युगे युगे टू एस्टैब्लिश धर्म आई कम दिस इज द ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ द लास्ट लाइन इफ यू लुक इनटू कृष्णाज लाइफ व्हाट धर्म ही टॉट ही स्टॉप्ड द वर्शिपिंग ऑफ द वैदिक गॉड इंद्र एंड स्टार्टेड द वर्शिपिंग ऑफ गोवर्धन हिल सो इन माई ओपिनियन इट वॉज द वर्शिपिंग ऑफ नेचर इन इट्स ट्रू फॉर्म So, taking care of nature and the holy hill, which Krishna himself worshipped, I think it's a very good thing for every Hindu to do. So, we are doing it. And it's a great privilege for me to be here. I am sitting in the lap of Govardhan Maharaj. That's why I don't want to leave. Yes. The government say between 40 to 50 million people every year they go around the hill. It is a tremendous electromagnetic energy and also tremendous bioenergy which is being created. And I am sitting in the center of it and I feel it. My own experience is what we may wish may not be the thing we actually need. So Govardhan Maharaj provides what we actually need, not what we exactly wish. So this difference is there. I was wishing only for 2 rooms somewhere so I will live peacefully and see what he gave us. I have done it 4 times. First in 91, then after I came here 3 times after that. For the sake of doing it. There was no particular object. But life changed dramatically after that. Kriya Yoga is a direct way to make your spirit your friend. Nobody is doing anything to make their spirit their friend. We are all out to please some unknown God about whom we have heard from someone or we read about in the books. But our spirit is inside us. It has come from the other side and it will go on the other side. So only your spirit can tell you the real mystery, what happens after death, how it was before you took birth. Make your spirit your friend and you discover all these truths. I think it is very difficult to face yourself. We are not ready to face ourselves. For this, you need to have a very strong and brave heart. You don't want to live with us, that's why not many people like to be alone. We are always going out to see other people. To enjoy your own company, it's a very great achievement. Kriya Yoga is only for special people who are out to find the answer what happens after death and what it was before birth and to make their spirit their friend. It is for them. It will depend on the individual. There are more than 10 stages. And also it depends how much practice and effort you are ready to put in and how ambitious you are. That would depend on that. And your physical capacities. Hatha Yoga has been introduced in a very wrong way. There is only one book carrying the name Hatha Yoga. And they talk about awakening of the Kundalini and about achieving Samadhi. But some yoga instructors who went to make money in the West, they introduced Hatha Yoga as only physical exercises. But it's a very mysterious form of yoga. Ha means prana, tha means apana. Joining of prana and apana is called Hatha Yoga. Just doesn't only that only exercise, physical postures are Hatha Yoga. The same Kriya Yoga which was given to Lahari Maharshi, what I have been practicing and I am teaching is the same thing. When I saw Babaji first time, he himself told me that. And it's a great honor to carry that parampara or the tradition on my weak shoulders. He is called Yogeshwar, the king of yogis. And his chief, Upadesh Gita, is a book on yoga. He was Yogeshwar. And I will tell you a sort of, it may sound like a comic thing, but it is real. You know, when many of our Puranas, it is written then when Radhaji was asked to take incarnation on earth, she said, until unless a portion of Golok and the Govardhan hill will come down to earth, I will not go. So a piece of Golok came down, 84 koshas, and the Govardhan hill. So because I don't know, it may be some phobia or something, I realize if something has come down, one day it will take off. So I want to be on it when it takes off, so I don't go out anywhere. That is a personal reason also. I don't want to be in Mathura or in other place and then I hear that it has taken off. No. So I want to be here. Sincerity, honesty, and a very open mind and heart, and a real desire to go all the way in the path of yoga. If you are seeking the answer that what happens after that and what it was before taking birth, then only your spirit can answer that. So only for those who want to find the answer to these questions, it is important for them. I have seen majority of happy people among those who were practicing Kriya Yoga. Very happy people. No depression, nothing, and they also develop a sense of humor on the way because their outlook about life is changing by their own realizations. Most of them are good people. Very happy people. Because I am not going out much, so I am not exposed to normal, so-called normal persons nowadays. So mostly those who are sincerely involved in Kriya Yoga, and I see happy faces among them. Of course, in such mundane times, if a person is looking happy, he is a different person than normal. Yes, a very good person. Yes. Actually, we are not capable of judging ourselves in the beginning. Only after you have gone a little bit ahead and when you look back, then you will realize that how much progress you have achieved. Suddenly you won't feel it, but it happens on a daily basis. Babaji gave this Kriya Yoga to householders, that means he cancelled celibacy also. But that doesn't mean that you must overindulge in sex or something, there has to be discipline in everything. It's open for everybody. What reason can be? I fail to understand that. Because at the time of initiation, we need to give our word that we will practice all our lives. So that means if Samaj is not strong enough to keep his word, such a person is not worthy of consideration. The main theme of preaching, religious preaching, karma this, karma that, I think if you worry too much about karma, you will never be able to evolve yourself or develop yourself. So do what is best for you. From the depths of your heart, whatever you feel good, do so. It is very much possible because first you will actually understand what is your destiny is, what path you are following. You will become extremely aware of that. And then if you think necessary, you may bring about some changes also. Without knowing exactly what is there, what you will change. Knowing is important. Paramahansa Yogananda has done a very good work in popularizing and introducing Kriya Yoga. Now a genuine seeker is free to find a genuine person. It's up to them. And I think you cannot lift a well and drink it. A thirsty person will have to go to the well. Well is always waiting for a thirsty person. His name, his family background is unknown. He never has said anything about it. And I was blessed with 2 times of his physical presence. First, it was on 2nd of April 1988, and second time here in Govardhan on 21st of December 1995. He is there. I was visiting Banaras for some work, to help another Guru Bhai there. And at about 2 o'clock in the night of 2nd April, there was a knock on my door where I was staying. There is a place of Swamiji, Kashi Mumuksh Bhavan. I was staying there on the first floor. There he came. And it irritated me that who is knocking on the door at 2 o'clock in the night. I was doing my own practice. When I opened, there was a young man standing there with long hairs, with half-sleeve shirt and a dhoti like a Bengali person is wearing. And he asked, what? And he simply said, I am the one who you know by the name of Babaji. Then I became aware of his aura, which was tremendous, and became frightened, nervous, and afraid at the same time. Even now, goose pimples are coming on me. Then I prostrated myself, and then he was there and he told me certain things which I still carrying out. The meeting lasted maybe 40 minutes, maybe 50 minutes. I'm not sure about that. Then he left. After 7 years, he appeared here again on 21st of December, early morning. Both visits were unexpected. And I don't know, I have heard some very romantic accounts of him visiting some people. But my reaction was, I was afraid, I was extremely nervous, and I didn't know how to behave in front of such a person. And after that, of course, it feels very good. And your confidence is touching the new heights. Your life is different after that. My life changed absolutely after that. First visit, the main conversation subject was Kriya Yoga. He corrected some things which I was already doing, and he added so many new things. And he also taught me something which I had to start exactly from my 57th birthday. The second visit, he was bare-bodied in the height of winter, just wearing a white cloth around his middle, in a very light mood, even making jokes, sometimes using bad words also, which made me even more nervous. Because there is such a powerful person who can strike you with lightning and fry you in no time. If he starts with smiling and laugh, you will become more nervous. It was nearly 2 hours. He left about, let's say, after 5:30 in the morning. There was one man also with him. Sadly, I don't even remember his face. I just remember vaguely that a man was sitting on the floor carrying something, and Babaji was sitting on my wooden dais. My sister came down, and Mahatmaji also was just there when they were leaving. My sister also offered her pranam to him. Oh, I didn't have enough guts to ask him that. In fact, it was like a one-sided discussion. I was just listening to what he was saying. I had absolutely no question. I didn't know what to ask. If you ask this question, then think. He initiated Lahari Mahasaya in 1861. Just look at the situation of the world before 1861 and after 1861. There was no democracy, science was not so advanced. But after 1861, suddenly democracy was introduced in India and science began to take giant steps in progress. The end of the 19th century and the 20th century is beyond imagination, the difference. I think Babaji might be playing a hand in this. This is what I feel. He looks, if I will think, anywhere between 25 to 35. And physically, he is very strong, extremely shapely. Not muscular like bodybuilders, but strong personality, very shapely. Still, it looks like a dream. Yes. I believe it myself, yes. My understanding is that if you read all ancient texts of Nath Yogis, it is absolutely similar to what we learn in Kriya Yoga. So maybe the source is one. Because people were trying to introduce and teaching people, so some different words were taken and the whole thing began. But they are the same teachings in yoga. That was another amazing thing. I was blessed with Masendranath's darshan on 16th of June, year 2000, in Mahurgarh, Maharashtra. I saw him face to face in flesh and blood, if he was in flesh and blood. Masendranath was more than 7 feet tall, very fair in color, black beard, black hairs. And his beard was as if clipped with a scissor or something. And he was walking with a little bit stoop, I mean not very straight. Very slim. And he is the first person who talked with me with such lovingly and very sweetly. He told me about these wearing these kundals, how to start a dhoni here. There were two ladies with him. They were also 6.5 feet tall. Extremely beautiful and very full of, what you say, valor. I mean, you will feel awe when you look at them. but he never introduced me to them. So, and I not had, didn't have guts to ask him.
Yogi Mahadeva.
I received a message from Ganganath. He came here, gave me a time and date and be there. He said, Matsyanath wants to see you, which was unbelievable for me. So I journeyed to that place and saw him. Well, he was a disciple of Gorakhnath, as we see in the lineage of Nath Parampara. He is also considered as an immortal person. First he came after we found the natural shivling and installed here on the cremation spot of a king. He came then told us so many things. Then again after some time, again he came. We just gave a message and left. I didn't see him the second time. There was a Guru Purnama time, big crowds were going around, and three Nath Yogis came and lay down in the veranda which is facing our main gate. One Nath remained lying down for 3 days. He was smoking something continuously. Ganganath will come inside and talk with my disciples. And as we had just installed the Shivling, so it was the hot topic of that time. And he said, I want to see your Guru, I want to have darshan of Shiva. Mahatmaji asked me, I said, okay, what's the problem? So when I went to see him in front of Babaji's temple, it was evening time, he saw me and began to say, you are Nathon ke Nath, Bade Nath. You invoked Abdhuta, which many Nath yogis were trying to invoke in Samshan but failed. You invoked it, so you are the Bade Nath, the most elderly Nath. I thought he's just buttering me up to extract some money from me, which is the usual practice among such people. But he was carrying 2 million rupees in cash on him. Then he told us so many things about the Shivling, the importance of it and other things we had found. And then he left. And then he also gave us some address in Punjab. So there was one relative posted in army, he was a major then. I asked him to go and see, and he found a very centuries-old tomb of Ganganath there. Ganganath himself was not there. So then we searched the Nath literature and came up that his guru was a direct disciple of Gorakhnath, and he and his brother disciple, Guru Bhai, Darshani Nath, they were here. Chandnath, Ganganath. Chandnath is the name of the Guru, Ganganath and Darshani Nath were the disciples.
Narumana anada kaha sukh par jaise ude jahaj ko panchi puni jahaj pe aave re mero man anad kaha sukh paave.
Samadhi is when your mind is totally conscious. There is no subconscious, no, they are all one. Absolute consciousness has awakened. Your mind is working 100%. That is Samadhi. I experienced Samadhi way back in maybe August or September 1985. And it was a very, say, traumatic experience first time because I was not ready or prepared for that. And then many symptoms of old age began to appear on my person. The hairs on my chest were going grey, hairs on my head started to go grey. Because if the body and nervous system is not prepared and if this experience comes, the body will take its toll. Then for two months I was just lying in my room doing nothing. Then I realized these things and began to do some exercise. reduce my step to do some exercise. And that effect began to be reversed after that. Then I made exercise a permanent routine, that I work out every day, no matter what. It neutralizes the effect of that. The way many people have described it in a very romantic way, that comes much later. I mean, not the first time. First time it is a traumatic experience. Consciousness was all over. Half of the city I was experiencing. It was night times. You don't want to look at people like that. Some are in toilet, some are having sex, some doing that, some doing that. And the smell of humanity is not tolerable. It is a suspended animated state, it's a death-like state. That's why the sign of old age comes, if you are not well prepared before. Maybe 1.5 hours, that's it. Or like as if your some leg goes to sleep, the whole body was like going back to sleep, then the blood circulation started, and the tingling sensation all over the body was overwhelming. Oh, I just felt stunned. I mean, happiness came much later. Yes. When you look back and then analyze, then you are happy. Not at that time, particular time. I think in yoga tradition, the guru decides about these things. Even though you will become capable of taking this decision, but as a mark of respect, you will let your guru decide, because he knows the best. He has much more experience than you. They say that for extreme yogis, 3 years, 6 years, 12 years, 24 years, 48 years is enough within one lifetime. No, it is part of that. You are realizing how advanced you can become, how much evolved you can be. Samadhi is part of that evolution. So if nobody is achieving samadhi, then there will be a little bit less than total self-realization. He can realize so many things about himself, but he will go on missing this. So this is also very important. If he is practicing yoga, or let's say kriya yoga. I think first these words were used by real yogis. Now, because many people have read them in books, so it's very easy to use different words. Yes. God realization, self realization, whatever, enlightenment. Before samadhi, before realization, cutting wood and fetching water. After realization, cutting wood and fetching water. But your mind will be different, your perspective will be different. Understand life. What can be a better purpose of life than to understand the life? I think ambition is very much needed here. And also, if you are ambitious and you have a certain ambition, then you should also work hard to develop your capacities to fulfill that ambition. They both go hand in hand. I think it is a very fine thing, because society was created only for trade and commerce, and money is the essence of it. So as long as you are in the society, you will have to accept the power of money. But you need to also to learn how to make money work for you. You should not be a slave to the money. Use it. Let it work for you. It will give you a lot of free time so you can perfect some arts, so many things. It is not all that bad. I think the main theme of living away from society is to don't become commercial. In Gita it is said a commercial mind is not aware of what is samadhi. Vyavsayatmika buddhi samadhauna vidhiyate. One of the chapters he says. If you are too much involved in commercial things, samadhi will remain not even a dream for you. You are not worrying about it. That's why yogis were suggested, don't involve in any commercial activity. It will give you a very free thinking ability if you are not involved in any commercial activity. And for them, I will suggest begging is the best business. You don't need a capital investment, and you don't need any office to do that, and the profit begins from the day one. The climax of life. So if you will understand life, you will also understand death. And speaking from yogic point of view, which is my point of view, joining of spirit with the flesh and blood body is called life. Separation of spirit from the body is called death. That's why making spirit your friend is extremely important. Body may go, body may come, but the life will continue forever. Everybody is afraid of the unknown. So we fear the unknown. If you will know what is going to happen, no fear. I think love is the most potent force in the entire creation. And sadly it goes missing, and those people are very fortunate who have experienced love in their lifetimes. And life may be there, life may not be there, but the love will continue. Yes. Because love is directly connected with the heart. And all religion in the entire world say that God lives in your heart. So if you are experiencing love, this is a direct grace or blessing from the God. I believe, and it is my personal belief, if some art is given by an immortal guru, it may be carrying some seeds of immortality or some ways to attain immortality in the art of Kriya Yoga. And I think it is open to anybody whomsoever is able to master it, he may become immortal. I think after you are immortal, only then you can sit down and relax and think something. Till then there is always a worry nagging you. Well, I will say leave some things to ponder in eternity. I think no one can answer it directly, or even if you will try to answer, not many people are going to understand that. So let the mind be developed and then we will ponder on them. I have written in my commentary of Shiva Sutras that the mind takes the body as a bride and makes it pregnant with the seed of consciousness. And the consciousness as a fetus grows in the body. That's why many saints of India have said that every body is actually a female. The male is only one, Shiva, or your greater mind. So when the consciousness is developed fully, it is delivered at the time of physical death, and now then it is one with the time itself. It's a sort of a poetic explanation, but it is true. Everybody should read Shiva Sutras. I will say we are also the body. Body is extremely important. That's why the soul or spirit keeps taking over again and again and again. So let's pay enough respect to the body also. Then your spirit will become your guru and your mind will become the disciple. And he will learn so many things from the spirit about what is life, what is afterlife, what is beyond that. And your Atma may even introduce you to the Paramatma. It's a step-by-step progress. I hope, yes. But I am friends with many spirits.
Yes.
Every friend of mine has a spirit inside, and if he is my friend, then the spirit is also my friend. I am not aware if they are experiencing it. My congratulations to them. I am a simple man, and maybe because I am realizing my true nature, so maybe the mother nature is supporting me and it may appear supernatural to them. But when you are practicing something very extraordinary, like Kriya Yoga, some extraordinary things will happen, start to happen around you. These are abilities which will develop if you are on the right track. Like aura will develop, so if your aura is powerful enough, others will be able to see that. If you will them to see it, they will be able to see that. So many things will happen, I mean naturally, without any sort of so-called supernatural powers attached to them. They are abilities. I have no claim, yes. I didn't become even a var. Var means a bridegroom. How can I have powers? I can give it very easily. Maybe it is the first time it is going on record. 71% of your body is water. And water is hydrogen and oxygen. When we are practicing very high pranayams, the oxygen level of your water content is going down. Because you are practicing breathless states, holding your breath for a longer time, and the oxygen content of your water is turning into different carbon, let's say carbon dioxide or something, it will be a different thing inside the body. But the hydrogen will remain unaffected. And then after a certain level, when you are able to remain breathless for 48 minutes exactly, hydrogen gas will lift you up. That is levitation. To me, it's very simple. Every religion who appeared on this planet in the history of mankind, all believed in one and the same thing. They all believed that life continues after death. That's why the hypothesis about heaven and hell was developed, and we were told to go through so many tapas and so many penances, so the God will be pleased and we will be allowed entry into heaven after we are dead. So if every religion is believing this, that there is life after death, that means there is life after death. There, Kriya Yoga becomes even more important. I told you, the main aim is to make your spirit your friend. It comes from the other side and goes back to the other side. So only your spirit can tell you first-hand experience of what happens there. We read so many things in books, but we don't know exactly. Yoga will give you that experienced wisdom. We don't differentiate between people. We welcome human beings. So, and we need to remember before being a Hindu or a Muslim or a Christian or a Buddhist, we are first human beings. And that is enough for me. Very regularly, for the last 25 years, we are seeing them very regularly. They keep coming. But I have a very different theory about it. I think that Earth is a very giant spaceship which is taking us somewhere, providing us with everything, every type of entertainment, politics, wars, whatever we want to do, giving us everything. So maybe the UFOs are part of the pilot crew. Hmm. So they just keep looking at us, are we doing okay? And that's it. They may not be aliens. It was done in 92, in 21 days, after my first parikrama around Govardhan Hill. Well, it was a great thing. I wrote Yog Darshan Commentary in 4 days flat. Shiv Sutra took only a single day. Hatha Yoga Pradipika took 8 days to finish. Maybe I'm in a hurry to do these things. Or let's say the Krishna's name in India is Hari. So people say Hari, Hari, Hari. They were saying Hari, Hari, Hari around me. So I hurriedly did things. All of them, Gita, Yoga Sutras of Patanjali, Shiva Sutras and Hatha Yoga Pradipika. And the 8th book which is coming now, the Gorakh book. Fantastic work. I think everybody should read them because by reading them, some understanding will definitely develop about the subject and may even give you inspiration to do it practically. Well, most of the commentaries were done by great Sanskrit scholars. And it was my misfortune or great fortune, I never was a student of Sanskrit. And most of my original ideas were recorded there. I will say very high stages, many of them have reached and they are working very hard and I am proud of them. Without a disciple, a guru is a nobody. So disciples are also necessary. And here I will say that very sincerely. In India it is believed that if a son surpasses the father or a disciple surpasses the guru, nothing can be better than this. It is the greatest compliment a father or a guru can receive. I hope this will come to pass. I have absolutely no idea. Maybe the only difference is I am absolutely ordinary person. All of them are extraordinary people. This is the difference. I think I am a simple man and a person who is really a seeker. In the mysteries of yoga, Kriya Yoga, I think he will find me. And I don't have to go out my way to advertise myself because Kriya Yoga is inviting special people, those whose mind is highly developed and their mind is open also, and they are not so having dogmatic views as well, with a very open mind and open heart. If somebody comes, I teach them. And this is not my business. I teach absolutely for free. How a disciple is taking care of the guru, that is his problem. But you cannot put a price to such great art or vidya like Kriya Yoga. This is my personal feeling. I have a very big family, yes. Well, that is another story, because in India, especially among Hindus, if a person is employed and is getting enough money in salary or in bribes, then he is the most suitable bridegroom. And because I remain unemployed from the very beginning, so no marriage proposal came by it. But loss is not mine. Loss is of that girl who missed me.